intensified when you're suffering. When you're suffering, you're focusing on Jesus Christ, God Almighty. You're praying, you're calling out, you're reaching out to God. You're asking for relief of pain. You're asking for medications. You're asking for your doctors to heal, help you heal through the Spirit of Christ. In your weakness and trials and tribulations, it works patience and experience and hope. All those things are good coming from God. Let's read God's loving action towards sinners, Romans 5, verses 6 through 11. And it reads, verse 6, "For when we were yet without strength, in due time Christ died for the ungodly." You hear many pastors say about when we was in our sin, God died for us. Even though we were sinners, God still died for us. "For when we were yet without strength, in due time Christ died for the ungodly. For scarcely for a righteous man will one die. Yet perhaps for a good man, some would even dare to die." Look at that. "For scarcely a righteous man will one die. Yet perhaps a good man, one should even dare to die. But God commanded his love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us." While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. This is a familiar passage. Many ministers, many of you have heard these words. "But God commanded his love toward us that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Much more than being now justified by his blood, justified by his blood being shed, we shall be saved from wrath through him. For if we, when we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of his Son, much more being reconciled, we shall be saved by his life." The life of Jesus Christ when he rose from the dead after 3 days in the heart of the earth. "And not only so, but we also joy in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom we have now received the reconciliation." Oh, powerful words indeed. Powerful words. And understanding God's loving action towards sinners. We are all sinners. Let's go to Isaiah, the 40th chapter, verses 1 through 8. Isaiah, the 40th chapter, verses 1 through 8. The greatness and treasures of God. Isaiah, the 40th chapter, verses 1 through 8. Powerful. As we continue to focus on the lesson for today by reading the daily home Bible readings leading up to our August the 2nd lesson. Let's begin Isaiah the 40th chapter, verses 1 through 8. Comfort ye my people, saith the Lord. Speak ye tenderly to Jerusalem and cry unto her that her warfare is accomplished and that her iniquity is pardoned. For she has received of the Lord's hand double for all of her sins. Talking about his people. Have received double for their sins. The mission of John the Baptist. Verse number three, and it reads, "The voice of him that cries in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God." John the Baptist crying in the wilderness, prepare and make straight the way of the Lord for his coming. "Every battle shall be exalted, and every mountain and hill shall be made low, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough places plain. Verse 5, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. The glory of the Lord. Oh, man. Oh. Grass withers, but God's words stand. Do we understand what that means? Grass withers, but God's words stand. God's word will stand. God's word is true. God is faithful. God is faithful. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. Do we understand those words? Do we understand those words? It's saying that God's word is true. Just like John the Baptist was saying, repent. That was the new way of coming to Christ, acknowledging your sins, repent. That is still true for today. And the glory of God shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. Okay, let's go to the lesson for today. The lesson for today. Sunday, August the 2nd. Let us begin. This is the summer quarter. We're in the Faith and Wisdom in James, August the 2nd, 2020. Our key verse, if any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God that giveth to all men liberally and unbraideth not, it shall be given to him. If you want to understand something, ask God for wisdom. Ask for it. Ask for it. In experiencing this lesson, the participant should be able to do these things. Consider the relationship between wisdom and perseverance through trials. Affirm the value of trials and hardship in making one a wise and more productive disciple. Pray for godly wisdom by which to endure life's trials and temptations. Key terms: complete, complete in part, sound, perfect, entire. Greeting, to rejoice, to be glad, salvation, Godspeed. Joy, gladness, delight. Servant, to make slave, someone who belongs to another. Testing, to test that which something is tried or proven trying. Trials, experience, temptation, going through something. Trials and temptation. Wisdom, insight, skills, human or divine intelligence. Why this lesson matters. People desire to be seen as wise. What is the source of wisdom? The letter written by James affirms that God gives wisdom generously and ungrudgingly to those who ask for it. Ask for it. The subject for today's lesson. Ask for it. Faith and wisdom. Faith and wisdom. The lesson in focus. In our Christian walk, we begin with faith. Along the way, we embrace God's wisdom that gives us the wherewithal to persevere through life's trials and tribulation. Brian Fisher shared a most fitting story about wisdom and perseverance found in www.wowforyou at Farmer's Mule. You see, the farmer brought the mule was not worth saving when it fell into a well accidentally, so he thought he would just put it out of its misery by burying it. Despite the farmer's best effort to bury the mule, showed after shovel full, the mule resisted until it was able to climb out of the well on top of the dirt that was thrown in after him. The mule, despite the fact that it was literally in a deep well, would not give up. The mule simply shook the dirt off the shovel, never giving up the will to live, to climb out of the well. We may all have fallen into a hole at one time or another, while we did not intend to. Some of us act like the mule and fight and fight and fight until we get out of the hole. While others may try a few attempts, but in the end just give up and stay where they have fallen. The difference between the ones who are able to climb out and the ones who utterly give up and stay in that hole is really a matter of one's overpowering desire to get out from under whatever is pushing you down or trapping you. For those who have this power, it is not a matter of hope to get out of the hole, but only a matter of when. We must have mule sense to know that what doesn't kill us makes us stronger. And if we don't have that sense, we must ask God to give it to us. Now, the lesson in context. James wrote his epistle during the times of extreme trial for the earliest Jewish Christian. Some, no doubt, were ready to give up, but the underlying message of James' epistle was for his listeners to be faithful. That was to put their faith into practice. James' public ministry lasted for about 30 years. It began when Jesus appeared to him, followed by James assuming a leadership position in the early church, ending with the execution by Jewish religious leaders around A.D. 62. He wrote his epistle around A.D. 45. We may view the book of James as the believer's practice living guide. James' practical way of writing presents several broad themes in his epistle: joy in trials, faith resulting in transforming lives, genuine faith produced good works, godly wisdom produced righteous living, and God's response to believers' prayers. James' perspective on trials produces character, echoes that of Paul, Romans 5 and 3, and Peter 1:1-6. Peter 1 and 6. James' writing about wisdom closely mirrors that of the Old Testament book of Proverbs. We broadly outline James into three parts: greetings, James 1 and 1, believing facing trials, James 1, 2 through 18, evidence of genuine faith, James 1, 19, 5 and 20. The powerful words of James. Insight. James realized that some of his listeners were discouraged. They were facing terrible persecution. They didn't know how to cope with this turmoil in their lives. They were at a loss. James told them in verse 5 to take an inventory of their lives. Take an inventory of their lives. If they lacked the foresight to know how to deal with their trials, they should ask God. Ask for it. Ask God. God would give it to them generously. The Greek word for generosity is haplos, which means singleness of heart. While the double-minded have two minds, God would grant believers who sincerely ask with a singleness and purpose. The purpose would be to keep the faith to persevere through their trials. The Jewish Christians did not need to feel embarrassed. God only wanted to bless them with what they needed. The exploration. You begin today's lesson with one of introductory stories to generate discussions among students about faith, talking about the old mule and the well. Faith, wisdom, and perseverance. As you explore the lessons outlined, you keep the following points of emphasis in mind. There is a distinct difference between knowledge and wisdom. There is a distinct difference between knowledge and wisdom. Good things often come only through hard work and discipline. Believers should try to find joy in the midst of trials and difficulty. At the close of this lesson, you should be able to commit to applying the principles of today's lesson in your daily living. All right, let us begin with the first outline. James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes which were